Hello, welcome. This is a slide presentation on Eric Johnson and his artwork based on a display that is in the Ferdy Lab in downtown Eugene, Oregon in May of 2017. Eric Johnson is an artist who has lived in Eugene recently and has been working in a form of drawing based on his observations and memory of images throughout the landscape. Eric graduated from high school in Bakersfield, California in 1963. This is a photograph of him at graduation time, and a handsome looking young man. He was then off to Reed College, Portland, Oregon, where he then spent a year in New York as an artist during his education there, and then went on to Indiana University to do his Master's of Fine Arts in painting. 11 years later, in 1974, we find Eric Johnson joining a commune in Santa Barbara called the Brotherhood of the Sun. This is an unusual photograph in contrast to the clean-shaven Eric. Also, his wife, Kate, told me that when he proposed to marry her some years later, she showed her father this photograph, who was quite shocked at the appearance. Anyway, at this time, Eric was involved in many aspects in the commune. It involved him herding goats and chickens and donkeys. He painted, did some painting there, learned computer accounting for the Sunburst Organic Foods, and then did data entry near the railroad tracks. He mentioned he was chased off by Puritans at one point. Eric's experience in art also parallels some of his experience with computers and computer equipment and computer programming. Also, Eric's travels are really extensive. He's actually been to all of the states except Alaska in the contingent United States. And this map simply shows a few of his locations where he lived for some length of time. He lived in at least 18 cities in 9 states for a considerable length of time during his growing up, undergraduate, graduate, as well as time in New York City. This is a photograph of his father, who is pretending to be a scarecrow in his garden in Elkton, Oregon, where he lived during part of Eric's time and travels. Eric was born in Southern California in this little canyon. Here's a little picture of it from a satellite photograph, and it shows Eric being really a part of the landscape, and the landscape plays an important part of his work, or it has in these last 10 to 20 years. This is a picture of Eric during his time in graduate school at Indiana University in Bloomington during the 1968 and 70 period. Now, to go back to a timeline based on his travels, he was at Reed College, as I mentioned, in 1963, New York City in 1966, back to Reed to graduate, and then go on to Indiana University in 1968. In 1970 to 74, he was an artist traveling around to various cities, working, and then in 74, he joined the Brotherhood of the Sun in California. In 1981, he's in Elkton and Roseburg, where he's working on a mini computer in the Roseburg Community College, again, combining this sort of, throughout his life, this technical aspect as well as his creative artistic aspect. In 1984, he's in Eugene working at KEZI-TV, and he worked at Chambers Communication. He was actually a sketch artist for some of the courtroom trials, one of which was the beginning of the Diane Downs murder trial. In 1985, he marries Kate Callison and moves to Eugene, temporarily at least in his travels, and that's when he comes to the University of Oregon to study computer animation and really combine his interest in computers and technology with his interest in the arts. And then in 1985, he starts a computer art company or computer animation company called Digital Artworks, where he works with a crew of people producing commercials, flying logos, various advertisements, and commercial computer animated pieces used in television and in the movies. In 2006, he joins Ken O'Connell for a sketchbook in Italy journey, which sort of launches him into sketchbook work. And then from 2005 to 2008, he's been moving between Eugene and South Carolina, where his wife's parents lived for a while, and then back to Eugene. Now, I'll go on to some of the pictures that Eric has on exhibit in the gallery, Fertilab Gallery. This one using a kind of a regular pattern in his work, which is this sort of several layers within the imagery. Here we have the sky, the steel blue sky, with a bird flying, and then on the foreground, these branches with leaves. He likes to work with a crayon, a French crayon called Crayon Duché, and he will work with this in a scale, in a sketchbook, usually of about 4 by 6 inches. And then he will sometimes transfer these into prints that he can exhibit. This one is an interesting one where, again, he's working with the pattern and the comparison between these elements of the visual world, much like a visual haiku. One could almost say, you know, bird flying, yellow leaves, blue sky is a kind of a way that Jane Harrison described his work. Now, he takes themes from the Northwest, particularly in the landscape, but also wherever he happens to be traveling. But here again, the winter, the beautiful, cool winter, very seasonal, much like the Japanese haiku, very seasonal oriented. Each one of these pieces, you can tell what season it is. This is winter, clearly. And the snow, the cool snow, the cool blues and blue-greens. Here, the fall with the leaves gone and the birch trees. And notice the gradation of the white birches in the foreground and then sort of gray birches back ways and then darker trunk birches further back. And then this beautiful kind of a haze on the top of the trees and then the green and dark green evergreens in the background. Here you have another sort of theme in his work, which is of these singular elements, a single bench on a hill, a single bird in a tree, things of that nature. Here, a dog on the beach. And then his treatment of the landscape, again, he's so sensitive to bring in the sky, what's going on in the sky, and then in the distant horizon, the kind of fog one sees on the ocean, where you can't really see where the ocean stops and the horizon line begins, the white waves, the beach, and then the dog on the beach. Themes of patterns, again, birds, birds, leaves, he loves to look at these things that have a kind of seemingly random pattern, but in fact have a kind of almost a pattern one could describe after watching it for some time. Here's Eric with some of these crayons that he uses, and you can see the spectrum and the range. Usually he works with a small portable set that he can take with him as he's traveling and working. Here are two, or actually, it looks like three different images because of the way he's divided the one on the right, but it's two images from the landscape, one dealing with this house and, again, the plains, the foreground, the midground, and then the background, beautifully drawn and describing the various colors and tones and contrasts between the shapes. Here again, this emphasis of the sky and the clouds as a background, the forest of trees in the medium ground in the lower part, and then the singular bird in the singular tree in the foreground. This was a group of four of his pieces using the aspects of light in the sky, artificial light in comparison to the sunsets, and then on the lower right, a beautiful example of using the negative space, the whiteness of the paper to come through as this sort of fog bank that seems to separate these two hills that we're looking at in the distance. Again, working with birds and trees, and here crows and starlings and their different patterns of flight. And he likes to simplify these things to their essence. And so if you look at the birds, they're really shapes, just simple shapes, but in a bird pattern. And so we identify, our mind sees them as birds, even though he has given just the bare essentials of a bird-like shape. Here you can see him actually in the working process. Sometimes he'll work from observation. Most of the time he's working from images he stored in his mind. But here he was at a cafe in Eugene, and here's the kind of window scene that he was sketching. And here you see him sketching and then also working with the crayons. This is Eric again as he's sitting in the gallery during a previous opening of the show. And then this is the conclusion of this system of slides and discussion of Eric's work. Thank you very much. I'm Ken O'Connell.